This class, we are going to start with the new chapter, that is mensuration. Okay, now in your lower classes you have learned about the area of a rectangle, area of a square, right? And then a cube and cuboid you have learned. In ninth you have learned about cube and cuboid, TSA, LSA, volume of a cube, volume of a cuboid, all these things you have learned. Okay. Now, in our first exercise, this chapter also has some formulas, okay? So, you need to remember all the formulas. So, in the first exercise, that is 7.1, you have about cone and cylinder. Okay, you have about cone and cylinder. Now, when you see about a cylinder, you all know the shape will be like this, right? This will be a cylinder. The top and bottom will be circles. Okay. Now, here in for cylinder, you have two things in this exercise. Okay. And that is, you have the TSA and you have the LSA. So, first thing you have about cylinder is TSA. TSA means what? Total surface area. Now, when you are seeing about total surface area, what you have to see? You have to see the whole thing. Okay, that is, you have, see, suppose if you have a cylinder like this, this is the shape of a cylinder, right? This is the shape of a cylinder. Now, when you are seeing the total surface area, you have to see this thing and the top as well as the bottom. Okay, all the things you have to see for total surface area. That is, when you see this round thing, that is what? Circumference. Okay, circumference, that is 2 pi r. Okay, circumference of the circle is 2 pi r and this is the height. So, 2 pi r h plus. Now, when you see the top and the bottom, what you have? Top and the bottom, you have the circles. So, what you will get? 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. This is pi r square. This also pi r square. So, what you will get? Pi r square plus pi r square, you will get 2 pi r square. So, the formula for TSA of a cylinder is 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. So, this will give you what is common over here? 2 pi r bracket h plus r. This is the formula for this one, total surface area of a cylinder. Okay, 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. Now, same way you have the LSA. LSA means what? Lateral surface area. Now, what do you mean by lateral surface area? This part and the height. Okay, two things are there. So, this will be 2 pi r h. This is the lateral surface area, or we say curved surface area. So, this is the LSA of a cylinder and this is the TSA of a cylinder. Okay, volume you have in the next exercise. Okay. And what do you mean by a hollow cylinder? Hollow cylinder means one cylinder inside the other. Okay, inside this you will have one more cylinder. That is what is hollow cylinder. Okay, that also we'll discuss. In that you will have two radii, that is capital R and small r. So, the formula will vary like that. Instead of R, you have to write capital R plus small r. That alone, the formula will vary. Okay, so first you learn about TSA of a cylinder. Next, you learn about LSA of a cylinder. How the formula came, and like that you understand and learn. Don't muck up the formula simply. Okay, so you won't remember. Now, the next you have about the hollow. Hollow, if you are taking, you will have two R's. Okay, so you have TSA of the hollow cylinder will be 2 pi. Instead of R, you have to write R plus R, then R minus R plus H. This much square units. Okay, that is the TSA of a hollow cylinder. One cylinder inside the other, that is called a hollow cylinder. Now, next thing you have about the cone. So, about the cone, what you know? This will be the top part. Okay. This is a cone. This will be a circular. And this part will be pointed. Okay. One side will be circular. The other side will be pointed. That is what is the this one, cone. Okay. Now, if you are talking about the CSA, anything you can write first. Okay. First, if you are writing about CSA. CSA or lateral surface area, both are same. Okay. CSA or TS, this one, both are same only. So, CSA of a right circular cone, that is pi r l. Now, what do you mean by this l? L means the slant height. This is the slant height. Okay, this is the slant height This is the radius and this is the height. Okay, this is the slant height, this is the radius and this is the height. So this is what is pi r l. That is the curved surface area of a right circular cone. Pi r l square units. Okay, now the next thing is TSA. TSA, see, for the cylinder we had two circles, no? So we had 2 pi r square. Here we have only one circle. So what you will get? You will get the formula pi r l plus pi r square. That's all. Okay, total surface area will be pi r l plus pi r square. This will be the TSA of the right circular cone. So what is common over here? Pi r is common over here. And inside you have l plus r. This much square units. Okay, so this is the TSA and CSA of a right circular cone. This is the TSA and CSA of a right circular cylinder. And then hollow cylinder you have like this. This is the hollow cylinder. This is about the hollow cylinder. Okay, so based on these formulas, we will start with the exercise 7.1. Okay, keep the formulas in mind. Every time when you do the sum, write the formulas. So it will be registered in your mind. Now we will start with the first one. The first one you have. The radius and height of a cylinder are in the ratio 5:7. So whenever you have the ratio, what you will write? You will write in terms of x, right? So the radius and height of a cylinder are in the ratio 5:7. And its curved surface area is 5500 square centimeter. Find its radius and height. So, let the radius be 5x and let the height be 7x. Okay. Now, CSA of a cylinder, what you have? 2 pi rh. Okay, CSA of a cylinder, you have 2 pi rh. Now, what is given to you? The CSA, they have given how much in the sum? 5,500. So, this is 5,500 equals, this is 2 pi into r into h. So, this is 2 into 22 by 7 into, what is the radius you have assumed? 5x. So, this is into 5x into 7x. So, multiply the right hand side thing and transpose. So, here you will get this 7 and 7 gets cancelled. Then 44 into 5 into x square. Transpose that. Cancel the 0. You will get the answer 25. So, x square is 25. X value will be how much? 5. Okay, x value will be 5. So, what is the, this one radius? 5 into 5, 25 centimeter. What will be the height? 7 into 5, that is 35 centimeter. Okay, so this completes your first one. So, they have given in ratio form, you have to write as 5x and 7x and then put the formula of CSA of the cylinder, right? Circular cylinder. Now, the second one, a solid iron cylinder has total surface area of 1848 square meter. Its curved surface area is 5/6 of its total surface area. 5/6 means 5 by 6, okay. 5/6 of the total surface area. Find the radius and the height of the iron cylinder. Okay, so here what they have given? TSA of the cylinder they have given as 1848 square centimeter. And what you have to find? CSA. So CSA, what they have given? 5 by 6 of the TSA. So 5 by 6 of 1848. Now you all know CSA of the cylinder is 2 pi rh, right? So 2 pi rh equals, you cancel this. When you cancel this, what you will get? 1540. Okay, cancel this and multiply by 5. You will get 1540. Now they have given the TSA as 1848, right? So given 2 pi r bracket r plus h. TSA of a cylinder, this formula. 2 pi r bracket r plus h. That equals 1848. So this is same as if you separated 2 pi rh plus 2 pi r square. That equals 1848. If you want, you can write this step directly, okay? Don't write this step, you can write this step also directly. 2 pi rh plus 2 pi r square. That equals 1848. Now, what is this 2 pi rs from the first one? We got 1540. So, this is 1540 plus 2 pi r square equals this one. So, 2 pi r square will be transpose that. You will get 308. Then you cross multiply, find the r square. So, r square you will get it as 49. So, say r will be square root of 49, that equals 7. So, this will be the radius. Now, what they have asked, find the radius and the height of the cylinder. So, what will be the height from this? You substitute, that is 2 pi rh. From 2 pi rh equal to 1540, from that you transpose and find the value of height. That is how much? 35 meters. Okay, the height of that is 35 meters. So, this is how you will do this sum. So, first they have given TSA, they have given 1848, and then CSA they have given 5 by 6th of TSA. So, that you multiply, you will get the answer 1540. Okay, that is a CSA. Now, write the TSA formula, 2 pi RH plus 2 pi R square. So, from that you will get the R value, that is 7. Okay, R value you will get, that is 7. Now, after getting the R value, substitute in this one and get the this one H value. Okay, substitute in that and you will get the H value. So, these are the two answers you have. Now, we will go for the third one. Now, third one, what they have told is, the external radius and the height of a hollow wooden lump. Hollow means one inside the other. That is hollow. Okay. One cylinder inside the other cylinder. That is hollow cylinder. So, hollow wooden log are 16 centimeter and 13 centimeter respectively. If its thickness is 4 centimeter, then find the TSA. Okay, so what they have given to you? They have given the external radius, they have given, and they have given the thickness. So, from that what we can find? We can find the internal radius. Okay. Internal radius we can find with the help of thickness and external radius. And length of that they have given. The length means what? It will be the height. Okay, see. This is the length of this. So, if you keep it like this, what happens? This thing becomes the height. Okay, so this this is the height. If you keep it like this, this is the length. Okay, so they have given the height of the log. They have given as 13 centimeter. The external radius is 16. And thickness is how much? 4. So, subtract both and you get the small r, that is 12. Okay, the small r, that is 12. External r, that is 16. And now use the TSA formula. TSA of which one? TSA of the hollow cylinder. Okay, TSA of the hollow cylinder, that formula you have to use. So, you have TSA equals 2 pi r plus r, r minus r plus h. So, here you have put all the things. Capital R is given 16, small r we got it as 12 by subtracting with the thickness. And put all that. Okay, so you will get 2992 centimeter square. Okay, 2992 centimeter square. So, this will be the TSA of the hollow cylinder. Okay, so as I told you, whenever you are doing the sum, please write the formula and do. For whichever shape they have given, for that write the formula. So, it will be easy for you to remember. Now, we will go for the fourth one. Now, fourth one, what they have told? A right angle triangle PQR where angle Q equals 90 degree. Okay. So, it's right angled at Q. Like this. Okay. The triangle is right angled at Q. And then what they have told is rotated about QR and PQ. So, here when you see this, this is rotated about, for see, when you are rotating it, rotating a right angle triangle, what you will get? You will get the shape of a cone. Okay, when you rotate this triangle like this, you will get the shape of a cone. So, two ways they are rotating. First, they are rotating along PQ, and then they are keeping it like this, and they are rotating along QR. Okay, two ways they are rotating this right angle triangle. And what they have asked here is, compare the CSA of the right circular cones so formed by the triangle. So, when it is rotated along PQ, what will be the CSA? And then when it is rotated along QR, what is the CSA? That is what they have asked. You have to compare both. Which is more or which is less, like that you have to compare. Okay. So, first you draw the figure, that right angle triangle, which is right angled at Q. Okay, it is right angled at Q. So, the figure will be like this. This is given 16 and this is given 20 over here. So, since it's a right angle triangle, we can find the other side, right? This is the hypotenuse, this is 16 and this is the other side we can find with the help of Pythagoras property. So, here you will have 20 square equals 16 square plus PQ square. Or you can write height, it's also you can write. So, this height will be how much? 20 square is 400, 400 minus 16 square is 256. So, subtract both, you will get 144, 144 root is 12. So, this will be how much? 12. Okay. So, if the triangle is revolved along QR. Okay, if the triangle is revolved along QR, so CSA you find pi r L. Okay, first when it is revolved around PQ. Okay, first you do for PQ. When you are doing for PQ, you will get CSA equals pi r L. So, when you are revolving it along PQ, what will be the radius? The radius will be 16. Okay, the radius will be 16. So, pi r L, you put the things, you will get 320 pi centimeter square. Same way you rotate it along this one. When the triangle is revolved around QR. So, when you are doing along QR, when you are rotating it along QR, which will be the radius? This will be the radius. Okay, PQ will be the radius. So, you will get R is 12. Okay, what is the PQ we got? PQ we got it as 12. So, this will be 12. So, CSA is pi RL. Put the things, you will get 240 pi. Now, this answer is 320 pi when you are rotating it along PQ. Now, this is 240 pi when you are rotating it along QR. So, we get CSA of the cone is larger by revolving it along PQ. Okay, CSA of the cone is larger when we are revolving around PQ. So, this is how you will do the fourth one. So, draw the right angle triangle first. Okay, find the height. PQ you find with the help of Pythagoras theorem. And then, two times you have to find the CSA. When it's rotating along PQ and when it's rotating along QR. When it is along QR, this will be the radius. When it's rotating along PQ, this will be the radius. So, accordingly your R will change, but same formula you have to use. And see which CSA is more. So, this completes your fourth one. Now, we will go for the fifth one. Now, fifth one, what they have told? Four persons live in a conical tent whose land height is given as 19 centimeter. Okay, four persons live in a conical tent whose land height is given as 19 centimeter. This is the land height. Okay. If each person requires 22 centimeter square of floor area, then find the height of the tent. So, what all they have given? The land height of the tent they have given as 19 centimeter. Now, for one person, how much area is required? 22 centimeter square. Okay. For one person, the area required is 22 centimeter square. So, for four persons, how much you will get? 22 into 4. That equals 88. Okay. That equals 88. So, from that, you have what all things you have? The area they have given for four persons, you are getting 88 centimeter square. So, first you find the height. Okay, this one. So, you will get this land height minus this one, radius. So, 19 square minus this one. So, from that, you will get the answer. 18.2. How we are getting the radius? Pi r square equals 88. From that you get the r. Okay, radius, this will be root of 28, that is 4 into 7. 4 into 7 means it's 2 root 7. Okay, so r will be 2 root 7. From that you get the height. So what they have asked here, then find the height of the tent. This is what they have asked. Okay, so slant height they have given as 19. Then area for 4 persons you will get 88. So from that what you will find? You will find the r. First do this and then find the r. Okay, and then come back to h. So h will be l square minus r square. So complete that, you will get 18.25 centimeter. This is how you will do the fifth one. Now we will go for the sixth one. Now sixth one, what they have told? A girl wishes to prepare birthday caps in the form of a right circular cone. Okay, you must have seen a birthday cap, no? That's the shape of a cone for her birthday party. Using a sheet of paper whose area is 5720 centimeter square. From a 720 centimeter square paper area, she needs to make what? Birthday caps. Okay, which is conical in shape. How many caps can be made with radius 5 centimeter and height 12 centimeter? Okay. So we will start. Now what are the things they have given? The radius they have given as 5 centimeter and the height they have given as 12 centimeter. So from that first you will find the slant height, because you need to find pi r l, no? For that you need the slant height. So slant height will be r square plus h square. Okay, slant height means this one. See, when you see a cone, this is the h, this is the r, and this is the l. L means the slant height. Okay, this is the slant height. So this is the hypotenuse. So l square will be equal to r square plus h square. Okay, so here the r is given as 5 and the h is given as 12. So you will get 5 square plus 12 square, that equals 169, root of that is 13. So this is the l. Okay, so CSA of one cap will be pi r l. That is 22 by 7 into 5 into 13. So what is the total area of that paper? 5720. So number of caps required will be total area divided by area of one cap. So this will be 5720 divided by this one. So you can transpose this, that is cross over this one. Take the reciprocal. Take the reciprocal over here, cancel that, you will get 28. So how many caps are required? 28 caps are required. Okay, so this completes your sixth one. Now, your homework for today is, do these example sums, okay? Write the formulas also in the classwork. Okay, what all formulas are given, that formulas also you write in the classwork. Till now, what all formulas you have learned? This one, CSA of the right circular cylinder. Okay, CSA of the right circular cylinder, TSA of the right circular cylinder. These formulas and all, they are given in the book. Please write it down in the classwork. Okay, that is right circular cylinders, TSA, CSA, and then you have about the cone. About the cone also you have TSA, CSA, and then about the hollow cylinder. This is the hollow cylinder. Okay, so these are the formulas we have learned till now. So please write these formulas in the classwork. And then your homework you do the example sums. Okay, do the example sums in the classwork. Now see, when you are seeing this sum, when you are seeing the road roller sum, the sum they have asked some two or three times in the exam, okay. When you see this road roller sum, what you will find, this is a cylinder, okay. Now the road roller will be going like this, okay. When it goes like this, what you have to find? You have to find the CSA, curved surface area. Okay, because it's going like this. See, the road roller is going like this. These two things it's not using. That pi r square and pi r square it's not using. Only this part it is using. So what you will find? You have to find the CSA for the road roller sum. Okay, see here when you see read the sum, A garden roller whose length is 3 meter long and whose diameter is 2.8 meter is rolled to level a garden. How much area will it cover in 8 revolutions? So for 1 revolution, you will find the CSA and then that you will multiply by 8. So diameter is given as 2.8 meters, height is given as 3 meters and radius is how much? 1.4 meters. So area covered in 1 revolution will be CSA of the cylinder, that is 2 pi RH. That you find, you will get 26.4. And then for 8 revolutions, you will get 26.4 into 8. That will be 211.2. So this will be the CSA. Okay, so please do the home example sums also. Okay, that are also important. Suppose if you see this one, a cylindrical drum has a height of 20 centimeter and base radius is 14. Find its CSA and TSA. So both the things are given. H is given to you, R is given to you. The CSA formula is 2 pi RH. Put it in the formula. TSA formula is 2 pi R bracket R plus H. That also you will get the answer. So that much centimeter square for both the answers. Okay, so do the example sums also. For hollow cylinder also you have. Hollow cylinder you will have 2 R's. Capital R also you have. Smaller R also you have. Okay. See, you have the, for the normal cylinder, you have 2 pi RH, right? So, instead of the R, you have capital R plus small r. So, the formula becomes CSA of the hollow cylinder, 2 pi capital R plus small r into H. So, put the capital R, small r. Sometimes the capital R and the thickness will be given. So, from that, subtract and find the small r. Or, this one. Thickness and small r will be given. You have to find the capital R. Anyway. So, find the small r. Find the capital R. H is given to you. Substitute in the formula. You will get. Then area covered by 1 liter of paint is 10 meter square. They have given. So, number of liters required to paint the tunnel will be divide both. Whenever they ask number of something, you need to divide. So, this will be 220. So, 220 liters of paint is needed for the tunnel. So this completes your 7.4. So please go through the example sums also.